I saw 12 birds the other day. I know there were 12 because I counted them. I do that sometimes. Not because I care. Just because I do. They're in a circle around a dead bird. Silent. No flapping of wings or song. Just silence. I stared at them, kind of shocked really to see something so ceremonial at random. A strong gust of wind rolled by, and they scattered, still silent, leaving the dead one behind.
That's where love should take you. Happily nowhere. I hear the dog barking. I don't have a dog. I don't even like dogs. It's Tuesday. Such a failure. 9. No, 10 years. Been playing you. Every day. And here I sit alone. Still playing you. I was 13 when I got my first clarinet. I opened it up, took it out of the box. It was like it was the first one I'd ever seen. It was so beautiful. It's shiny. The keys are all smooth when I touched them. The reed was fresh like it had just been cut off the tree. I played it every day for almost 10 years now. Nothing could make me happy. I play on my clarinet. I remember playing a piece I'd written for the first time in Gossamer Park. It was a musical interpretation of Alice in Wonderland called All in a Golden Afternoon. It's not the score from the Disney movie. It's one I wrote myself. I saw the movie when I was a kid, but I never read the book until I was almost 20. I was Alice. I was the rabbit, the cat. I was everyone in the story. Disney version. It's actually a combination of Lewis Carroll's Alice in Wonderland and Through the Looking Glass. So they cut out a lot of really good stuff from both the stories. I mainly focused on Alice in Wonderland for my score, though. It made me a curious little girl. And I hoped it could do that for everyone else. I was the lost child, confused, in a wonderful world that slowly became violent and frightening, something that you want to escape from.
On the day I first performed Golden Afternoon, two young black men and a very young white girl, they took from me the only thing that I had left. They took my clarinet, tried other instruments. It's never been the same, it never will be the same. I didn't even make it a quarter of the way through.
I can't even play this damn thing. In Paris, 1909, F.T. Martinetti gave his futurist manifesto to the world. We will sing the love of danger, the habit of energy, and boldness. The essential elements of our poetry shall be courage, audacity, and rebellion. We declare that the splendor of the world has been enriched by a new beauty, beauty of speed. We wish to glorify war, the only health giver of the world. Militarism, patriotism, destroying arm of the anarchist, we glorify. Contempt for women. We wish to destroy the museums, the libraries, fight morals, feminism, and all opportunist meaning. Those cemeteries of wasted efforts, those calvaries of crucified dreams.
It was the 90s. Who didn't try to kill themselves or starve themselves? Generation X is dead. This is Generation Y. But why bother? I tried as hard as I could. Be true to myself, my work, the fact that I have to sell it off to be in some stupid car commercial, to sell some stupid product, just to stay alive. So willing to give myself to the world, give my work to the world free.
No, it will be the 13 when I got my first clarinet. I hope to do that for everyone else.
No, it will be the same
failure. It made me curious little girl. I hope to do that for everyone else. I was 13 when I got my first clarinet. I hope to do that for everyone else. It made me something that you want to escape from.
It makes sense. When this temple is soiled and broken up, it must be torn down.
Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in the morning. No one could be sweeter than my sweetie when I meet her in the morning, where the morning glory twine around the door, whispering pretty stories. I long to hear once more, rolling with my girlie, where the dew is pearly early in the morning. Butterflies all flutter up and kiss each little buttercup at dawning. If I had a land lamp, only I'd